So today's video will show you how to replace a hose bib or outside faucet. So I'm using a SharkBite half inch push to connect hose bib. So my previous hose bib was leaking really bad from the vacuum breaker. So I looked for a YouTube video on how to replace that. It says you have to drill out a little set screw that's in there. And it tells you to be careful not to drill straight through your hose bib. Well, I wasn't careful. I drilled straight through it. So you can see I've already removed my old hose bib. All I did was turn off the water from the inside and cut the copper pipe, and it wasn't screwed to the house, so it was really easy just to pull straight out. The new hose bib I mounted on the outside of the house with some screws and some silicone caulking. I did put about 12 inches of PEX on it and went ahead and pushed that through the existing hole in the brick. So here's the main water line that comes into my house. It has a branching half-inch line that runs out to the hose bib. And with a shutoff valve on it right there. Your first step is to locate your shutoff valve and go ahead and turn the water off there, and go ahead and open up your existing hose bib and let the water drain out. Your second step is to remove any pipe that actually needs to be removed. My copper pipe actually had 3 90 degree turns that led it out to the hose bib outside, so I chose to remove the copper pipe right after my shutoff valve, and I cut it just using a normal half inch pipe cutter. I ended up using two 90 degree SharkBite push to connect fittings, one to connect to the PEX that's coming through the brick wall, and the other one is to connect it, the PEX to the existing copper pipe. So here you can see where I ended up using the push to connect fittings. So you can see the one that's connected to the existing copper, and you can see the one connected to the PEX that's running through the wall that's connected to the hose bib outside. So I've cut the PEX to the length that I need. I needed two pieces, and now I'm marking the insertion depth so I can know how far it needs to go into these SharkBite push to connect fittings. It's a half inch pipe, so it needs to go 0.95 inches in. So I'm inserting the PEX into one of the 90 degree SharkBite fittings. You can see I'm pushing it down till the collar is right at my insertion depth that I marked. Now I'm inserting the PEX pipe into the other fitting, and you can see making sure that it goes all the way down to my depth marking. For the 90 degree junction of PEX pipe, I'm actually going to use a plastic 90 degree connector with cinch clamps. Here I'm making sure that the clamps are actually on first before you put the fitting on, because you can't get the clamps on after the fitting's already seated. So I've got the clamps on both sides. Now I'm pushing the fitting in, and it's a little difficult to get it into the second pipe, but eventually I do get it to seat all the way. Now I've got both cinch clamps in the right position, and I'm going to use the cinch tool and clamp them shut. Now my connections are made. I'm going to test my pipes, so I'm going to turn my shutoff valve back on, check for leaks. So I don't see any leaks, so now I'm going to test the outside hose bib. So there's the finished hose bib, and it looks like it's working just fine. So I really like this SharkBite push to connect hose bib. It's really easy to use, really easy to install, looks nice. So I definitely recommend it. It doesn't come with its own vacuum breaker, so I did have to buy a new vacuum breaker, and I did install it. Well, that's it. So if you like my channel, please subscribe.